All right, my model fiends, check it out, Mobius the Grim Reaper. I snatched this bad boy up. Just finding it in stock right now is pretty hard. The kit just came out. I will post a link in the description where I got mine. Hopefully you can get on a back order list and pick these up when they come back. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box. Of course, you saw the box top there. It looks like an old Aurora kit, and so does the manual. I'm really excited about this one. This is going to be a full build review. Lots of parts in this figure kit. You've got some options for grass, tombstones engraved. You got a grave marker and the figure and the sigh and a tree, and then paint it all up to look like the box top. So that's easy enough. First thing up, the cool base. You'll see on here that it has space for the Reaper, his sigh, so they actually sit into the ground, two tombstones, and the tree. And then a grave marker, which would be cool if they had an emblem or a decal for this to say the Grim Reaper or whatever. It is plain, so I'll have to hook myself up with someone that makes decals or something. On the back, you have a bunch of holes that are not opened all the way through so that you can decide what you want to place on the base of the included extra scenery parts. Next up, the cloak. Very nice looking. Of course, this is all going to be done in a very dark color. Huge locator pins. We'll have to see how those go together without seams. Now, I have built other Mobius kits before. Never really had a big problem with seams on the figures. These are the optional grasses. That's what a bunch of those holes are for. And there's a lot of them. You can paint them up. Dead grass, half alive, half dead. It's going to look pretty cool. I was planning on getting out my Model Railroad parts and pieces and putting some more scenery in it like I did with the Halloween build and the Deadwood build, but or the Deadpool build. But I don't know if I'm going to have to with this one because they include so many extras. There's the dead tree. Look at those cool branches. That's in two pieces as well. Very, very cool. Let's look at some more plastic in here. We've got the tombstones. We've got the giant sigh. We've got more parts of his cloak. The tombstones has some cutesy sayings on them. Here lies Frank, loved the dance, now he waltzes with the ants. R.I.P. Jeffrey fell from a belfry. Of course, you could turn those around, face them plain if you wanted to make a decal, or paint your own thing on the front of them, or carve your own thing into the front of them, for you super talented people that I'm jealous of. The sigh is enormous. It's got his arm attached there, you can see the size of it, the size of the sigh. Huge. And parts of his cloak, front and back. Take a look there. We've got some final pieces here. We've got part of a base here. Looks very nice. We've got clear plastic for the sand timer. Very cool. And we've got his hood, the gorgeous skull. You know what my favorite thing about painting this figure is going to be? I don't have to paint eyes. And a rope for his belt that will hang free, give you that 3D look. And then more cloak action for over his skeleton arms. It's all beat up and whatnot. So I'm going to start throwing everything into the parts wash and start doing some sub-assemblies. I'll be back soon. Hello again. I told you I'd be back before I started painting everything up. Well, we've got all the sub-assemblies put together. Now I can start doing my paintwork. The Frank's gravestone is all assembled. Looks wonderful. No issues. There haven't been any real issues with fit that you would not expect with a plastic model figure kit. I haven't had to do any seam filling aside from what glue I've used. There is one tiny gap left that will be seen. That's this, which is actually covered with glue. So when the paint's on it, that'll be smooth, but you can see it. So I figured, well, I'll show you, but it's not anything that you're going to see. You can see how everything else fits together nicely. No seam work to be seen. Now, you see seams up here, but the way I'm going to show you in a second, you're never going to see those again once we get everything back together and start painting. The tree goes together well. Even if you're dumb like me and on one of the branches you cut off the locating pin, I just glued it into place and held it, and it stayed just fine. I'm going to decide what else I want to do with the tree as I go along. Of course, I'm going to be painting everything black a flat black to give me my shadows and his robe color, and then we'll be highlighting things as we go from there. But the tree goes together well, so that's right there. Now on the base, all these holes on the bottom, I'm going to be punching through with a hobby knife so I can add all the grass, which is staying on the tree. I'm just going to cut off these ejector marks here, these pins, so that I can get a good paint coat on those. Those will be painted entirely with different blacks, greens, grays, and browns, and light yellows to get them all different looking. Then I'll punch out every single hole in here and attach it. I may also be attaching some other things I don't know quite yet. The side goes together well for being made out of multiple pieces. With the handles, a good quality glue. You can see the seams, even the seam in the hand, which joins up here. Sand it, pre-fit it, sand it a little bit. This is all the sanding I've done on the entire kit, is just using this one stick. It was brand new when I started. So honestly, very little prep work needed. Get that blade attached, sand that back to a point, get the side together with his arm. That fits so well that when he's on the base here, I actually have to do it out here because it fits so tight, but his bones, his arm, actually slide right in, and then it goes on the base, and then you'll align it on the base with where they both sit, and then push his pins in, and there you go. So that's already together. That's an amazing fit. Now up here, where the top of the cloak is, you can see those holes. You can see the seams inside there, because they're completely hidden once you snap the skull in. That's going to be very last step for me. Before I'm all done, I'm going to paint up the skull and then snap it into place in those two holes. But I want to be able to paint the cloak and shadow it. Now that just pulls out. And I said I'd show you. It's a tight fit, and that's what you want. But that snaps down in there, and look. The seams went bye-bye. Can't see the seams in the top of the arms anymore, so why would you ever bother sitting there and filling them? They look great. It looks wonderful. It hides it. It snaps over the top. Now, this had some seams in it. Completely gone. Completely. Throw the nice quality glue on there. If you use a good glue, you hardly have to do any seam filling on a good fitting model. And even on bigger gaps, it'll fit tight. Another thing I need to assemble is his hourglass, but I want to paint the inside a sand color on the bottom. Then I'll press it together. That's a press fit. Use a little clear part cement. Make it all go away. So I'm going to take all this over, all these parts over, except for the clear glass, and hit them with a flat black. And then I'll start doing some detail painting, bringing out some highlights using pastels and other techniques on his robe, which I plan to show you. We'll see you soon. All the parts have been primed with a nice flat black primer. What you can see I'm doing now is things I've shown you before. I'm doing the base coating so that when I start detailing, I've got my colors underneath already. I've already coated the entire base over the black primer with a thick coat of russet in a craft color. But as you can see, there's still black all over the place. And obviously, that's not going to get painted a ground color because that is a headstone. Then I've gone in with a hunter green and I've covered up, 85% of the brown. Except for where figures and stuff are going to be, because why would I mess in there? So that I've let dry. I keep drying it with a heat gun. You've seen me do that a million times. Then I'm going to go over it with a lighter shade of green, just dry brushing, like I've shown you, where I dip the paint in, rub it out on the paper cloth here, and then go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. That'll give me three shades of depth. And each time you do this, you get another shade of depth. Then once that's all done, because it is sort of a death scene, I've got a camel color, and I will dry brush that on top of everything. That'll give me my dirt, my darker, healthier grass, my lighter dying grass, and my dead grasses on the base. I've cut out all the holes for the other pieces of grass that are going to stick in, and I might, if I feel like it, drill some holes and have some paint stem stalk sticking up from the bristles on a paintbrush, make it look like dead tufts of grass and brush. So I'm going to keep working on that. You can see everything else is primed up nicely, looks great with that flat black. The tree I'm going to be doing almost identically to the base, except I won't be using much green at all. I'll be using more browns and grays. The figure is painted, and I like how it turned out. What I'll do after that is I'm not really going to do any more black work on that figure I will just start getting my pastels out if I can find them and start using pastels to lighten up the high areas, and the cloak will be done. I like that basic black. I just want to highlight some areas on it, and then that'll be done. I've got a wood tone, the black plastic for the sai and the steel blade. The steel blade, I'm going to try to use some more of my Molotow chrome. I'm thinking of right now painting the blade and then just making the very edge of the blade the super shiny sharpened end. But I've got a wood tone, this plastic, and that'll be done in the normal manner. It's already painted black. All I got to do is go over it with some dry brushing of a wood tone that I prefer, and then seal it up and then paint that hand a bone color before I stick it in. The skull, I did not prime. I want to paint it a bone color, so it's not going to matter. And I'll be doing a wash on that to shadow it anyways. Everything else is just moving along nice and quick. I'm just going to keep working. I've got to paint the stones gray with some craft paint. I'm going to try to weather those up just a little bit. And then I've got to find some other materials to accent the tree and the headstones and whatnot. So I'll keep plugging along, and we'll be back for a progress report in a little bit. Check it out. A lot farther than we were before. I've got the base toned in, and that's just a tone under there. I've got the gravestones assembled, weathered, painted. I wanted this one to look like actual stone, and I wanted this one to look like marble. So that's what I've done with those, and then made some staining. This is all dry brushing and whatnot. So we've gone over these techniques before. You know, this is the palette that I'm using of craft acrylics, and I'm only using two brushes. And I'm applying it lightly, and I'm wiping it off, and applying it lightly. And it's okay if you only use two brushes, because you want the colors to intermingle. The tree is the exact same way. Multiple colors over that black base, and then it's been gloss coated, so I can apply some more weathering and pastels and whatnot. The tree's going to fall over, because I don't have time to shove it back in the base. So now, remember that Woodland Scenics thing I built, the shipwreck? I have all this left over ground material, and I have it from other projects too, but I mean, this one's so convenient because I know right where I left it. So I'm going to start adding some ground effects with some scenic cement to cover up the plastic, and I'll be splattering it on and gluing it on and dragging it over and stuff. So we're going to get the base all done, we're going to get the tree all done, and once that's ready, and once that's ready to go, then I will get the figure out and I will start working on the figure. You can see that I already started painting the sai in the wood tone. Haven't done the blade, haven't done the arm, haven't weathered it or anything, but I just let that dry. That was done in craft paint again over the black. So I'm just going to keep working on this stuff and come back for little updates as we go. Right now what I'll end up doing is spraying this whole base with that real light mixture of scenic cement, and then I'll end up drizzling some grass, some moss, and other objects and bits and bobs onto that base to make it look real cool. See you in a little bit. Moving along, we're getting really, really close to the finish. So far, I'm only about 7 hours into this kit from when I showed you all the parts. So it's going together super nice, super easy. We've got the figure assembled himself. He is black coated. I sprayed him black, and then I painted him black to make sure that he is black through and through. And then I flat coated him. So he's got just a little bit of a shine, but not much at all. And we'll get rid of that in the end. I painted his belt a russet color, a very deep russet. Same with the rope that hangs off his belt, and then did a little wash on those with just black paint and Windex. The base is done. The base is completely done. Isn't that pretty? Just waiting for a lot of that white glue to dry, but that's not a big deal. Stones are done, streaked, weathered. Beat up. This one's like an old marble with some black stains running down it. This one's more like a regular stone. I'm still looking for some sort of emblem. There's nothing in the box that would have been cool with a decal or some sort of thing to say Grim Reaper, but hey, I'll figure something out eventually. Not during today, but I'll figure something out eventually to go on there and kind of give the kid a name. The sai, I've got the handle painted and cleared so that it looks like it was used and weathered in real wood. Just got to do the hand and got to metallicize the blade. The hourglass has not even been started. That won't take long. Just a touch of sand-colored paint on the bottom inside, and then glue it together and paint the cute little frame around it. You can see that nice little frame around it. And that'll hang from his belt as well. That hangs from his belt here. His rope from his belt hangs there. What we're going to do now, I'm going to show you the technique that I told you I would, and I've just been kind of experimenting with this. Now, it's going to look a little stark right now, but to make the high point shine a little more and the low point stay dark, we're just going to use some chalk pastels. And this is kind of the same way that I highlight like a car chassis, but I use a silver pencil instead of a pastel. This one I want to cover more area. So now don't freak out or anything, but I'm just going to run over the high points and just let the, don't shove the pastel into the body. Don't shove it down, because then you're going to just go into the low points too. I just want to cover the high points with a little bit of the pastel. Now see how that's quite stark, and we don't want that yet. Now I've got some white. I'm going to do the exact same thing. The exact same thing. Just lightly pressing down, letting it follow its own path. Okay? So now you can see where that's highlighted everything. Well, that's way too bright. That's too much. So we'll blow some of the dust off. And you just take your good old fingers, all right? Best tool you have. We're going to start brushing it off and just leaving a little bit there. Now you see how it's starting to stand out, but it's not as strong. We can wipe that on our towel. And you're just going to keep wiping that down until you cover the high points with the areas that you want to highlight, and you leave the low points. Now again, that's still pretty stark, but when we clear coat this, when we're all done, that clear coat's going to dull that out and mix it in. So you can see where we have dark in the dark part of the robe and lighter in the light. Now when I shoot that with my clear, that's going to even it all out. I'm going to continue doing this on the whole figure, front and back, all the way around, until I highlight all the high points, leaving the dark ones dark in the middle and in between. You can see that. And then I will go and clear everything. Then I've just got to paint the face and do some very small details, put them together, put them on the base. When I come back, we'll be done. And lastly, we have the final on Mobius's spanking brand new Grim Reaper. Check it out. I detailed up the base, made it look all mossy and old. Dead grass, live grass, moss, Spanish moss hanging from the tree, all kinds of goo. It's even got moss and weathering on the back of the tombstones. We've got them beat up. We've got them looking like stone. We made sure you can still read the letters for the most part. We've got this one over here looking like marble and then weathered. And I love how the base has it tilting backwards because old tombstones always fall down. And then we have the master of ceremonies himself. Now, I don't know if the light's picking it up enough, but you can see on the high points where we did that chalk, that pastel chalk, on all the high points does show up as a nice lighter tone. Yet when we clear coat it over it, it dulls it down a little bit so that it's not so garish. It doesn't stand out as much, but yet it doesn't give you just a simple black tone on the figure. And he came out beautifully. I love the way he assembles that skull with a little bit of skeleton bone paint and some black in the eyes and the nostrils, and then a nice wash across there comes across so nicely. I put some buttercream paint in the timer there, in the hourglass, for that to show up nicely, and then glued that to his belt. Got his rope for his belt hanging down. And then we've got, of course, the giant Psy. And you can see the metallic effects. It's so tall, we'll have to lean it up there, but we've got that metallicized. We got a little black band of iron to hold it in. And then I ran the Molotow chrome pen along the edge to give it that sharp edge look. So I love this. It would have been beautiful just as it is out of the box, but I can't leave anything alone, so I had to plastic it up with some more grass and weeds and dead plants. And I used every single piece in the kit too, all the fake grass in the kit, washed it out, dry brushed it, made it look real nice. So he is a very cool looking figure. I love it. I got to find a little display case for him so he doesn't get covered in dust. You can see I even covered the crotch of the tree with moss and everything growing up the dead tree. So I love it. Pick this kit up. There'll be a link in the description where I got mine. We'll see you at the next review.